Welcome to Linda's TV show. If it is your first time, you like the channel, you like the program, subscribe and put on your notification bell because it's gonna help you to know when I upload a new video. Like you all may know, I present information across the globe, especially in Nigeria to be precise, and I want to appreciate my viewers, my subscribers. You guys are so amazing, especially those who always tune in to watch me each time I upload a new video.
Israel day on fire now, Jerusalem. Missiles, pa pa pa. People are dying, oh. Seriously. That's what is going on in Israel. Fights, they are killing each other, you know. It has been a while. You don't take away they happen now. You know, say one day where they talk and for my live video, say what day Israel. Now I want somebody say what day Israel. Now I can't they work out for streets. And I can't talk, say, this guy don't know what thing they happen. These people, they fight with technology. Lucky to find yourself in Israel. There are things you mustn't do. Israel is not Canada. Israel is not America. Israel is not United Kingdom. And Israel is not Europe. Israel is just good to come and hustle and go. Mind you, Israel is within the Middle East. So now, in Middle East, the only country where they give people their passport now Israel. The rest of the countries not they give where they Middle East. You must know that. Even in Asia, majority of the Asian country not they give passport, except the Europeans. Now, what makes you the different? What makes Israel different from other country? They are a democratic country. Just like any other country, you come, the party. Majority of us think that when you come to Israel, Israel is a pastoral country. Like, it's just, yes, it is religion. Now, religion country, but life day for Israel. But not in Jerusalem, the old Jerusalem, no. But make me not go that side. If you come to Israel, don't, you see, waiting it, make you not go engage in marriage. Wait, to take my opinion. This is my own opinion. I want you guys to understand that my opinion is different from, you can take something from my own opinion. If you want to marry, you marry. But I prefer to tell somebody that when you come to Israel, don't marry. Actually, waiting me at the tell people be say, make you marry before you travel out. Get Pekin. If you plan to travel out, make you go get Pekin so that you go dead serious. Now, let me start by telling you that, okay, make you no marry when you come Israel. The reason why I talk say don't marry when you come Israel, be say if you marry the Oyibo of Israel, I no talk say now all of them, some people there where they marry Oyibo, where we say that they do well, but I get people, and we know people where we say this thing don't put them into problem for a long, long time. Do you know why? If you marry Oyibo for Israel, you can't bomb Pekin for you. When I can't go, they go police station. You know, say no marriage, where not they get problem. If when I begin, they go police station now and then, now and then, now and then. You see that paper where they give you? They go block them. They will not allow you to go to your country again until your child is 18 years old. That is why I say when you find yourself in Israel, behave. Israel is good. When you come, hustle and go. Now, imagine if you're like 30 years old. By the time your child will be 18 years old, how old do you think you'll be? How old is your mom? How old is your dad? How old is your uncle? A lot of them, maybe two or three go don't die. They will not allow you to go. It's very, very hard. Once you have a child with Oyibo, the reason why they no go allow you go be say, because you and the woman, they get quarrel. If you go, probably you no go come back to take care of the child. So you go become government property. So that's the reason why they don't want you to go when you're having problem with your wife. Especially if you have one or two children, all of them or three, all of them must be 18 years old. Where we say they go and go, they serve government for soldier. Then you can go. And now ask me, that ID where you get, it becomes useless because you are old. And Israel is not an entrepreneur state. When I say entrepreneur, not Israel, not too big. It's not too large for business. Do you understand what I'm saying? So, for you to come to Israel, behave yourself. Spend your years. Go back home and marry. Now, my opinion, I know say make una no marry. People will marry, they will. People will marry here, they. Those, they know some way they suffer, Yes. Some, they tell us, say, hey, my brother, waiting at the face. Some go call me, some don't. Make I tell you now, one Ghana man don't see me the time where I just come this country. You see me where I sit down, he can't call me, say, you just came? I say, yes. He say, please, make you no marry you. I say, why? He say, my brother, look, I got the paper now, but I'm useless. He got stroke. He say, I don't have a house in my country, in Ghana. If not, I will have gone back to Ghana. I pick up something from what he said. He was having a stroke. That brother was having a stroke. He said, I fight for this paper. Now I come to pick my child here. My wife is coming to pick me. He there with his wife. But what he was telling me that don't wait for this. If he had known, Ingo don't build her for Ghana before they go home. But he no get anything to fall back at home in Ghana. That's number one. When you come to Israel, mind. Number two, if you marry black lady for Israel, you are intent to get paper now zero. Say, okay, you find a Nigerian lady or Ghana or whatever you want to marry. Your intent to get paper is very, 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 very on zero. Do you know why? They don't want you. But you're picking where you're born, a citizen. Sometimes they bundle the mama, bundle the papa, deport them, go back home. Yes, it happened. Make you not ask. Sometimes they go bundle papa, send papa home. And leave the woman to stay and take care of the child here. The woman go get paper. The woman will be your wife again. The woman is not your wife again. Because body not be wood. You not go fit close up forever. And you not go fit come back. So a lot of people have faced that kind of problems. Once they go, and that person take over their wife. So be careful. Number two. If you come to Israel, there's a time limit in Israel. All of us get time limit. Those of us that are in Israel, we have time limit. 4-5 years, your time up. When you come to Israel, you go for refugees. That is what they know we come for. They know. Inside them, we come to hustle to get money for greener pastor. But then, you go collect refugee. After 2 years, 3 years, or 4 years, they go call you for interview. When you go for interview, you will never pass the interview. If you pass the interview, it's just your luck. And even if you pass the interview, they're still going to call you back and cancel the paper in the later future. So your lifespan in Israel is just between 4, 5, 6 years. You are done. You become wanted. That's the truth. I say it the way I see it, and it's true. So now, for you to come to Israel and compete with people, listen, there's a place I'm going. Because a lot of you, when you come to, people where they're Israel now, they hear me. Many of them, they do competition for home. If you come to Israel, you don't need to build 3, 4, 5-story building. Some people, they build 3-story building. Some people, they build a kind of house that they know if you finish for 5 years. By the time you're building the house for 4, 5 years, not be to put block, be problem. To put block, not be problem. Now, to finish, do the finishing. That is where problem is. So now, waiting at the observe, you say, some people, for their village, you get one, maybe one. Sorry guys, somebody is calling me and I'm supposed to give him his check. And now, so what am I trying to say? I know he's still going to call back. So for some people, like, as I was saying, they get some people where we say for their village. You get somebody where they're Canada. You get somebody where they're UK, where they get paper. You get somebody where they're America, where they get paper. Where we say they build house for their village. Him to one buy, he want to compete with that person where they're America. Competition no good for this life. Cut your coat according to your size. You see that person where they're America or Canada. In get paper. If it take 20 years to build that estate where you want. But for you in Israel, you have only 5 to 6 years only. So why are you building upstairs? Why are you building millionaire house? When you know you are just here, you are just a boy washing plate. What should you do? What you should do is do what? Build 3-bedroom flat for yourself. build like 2-3 bedroom flat for yourself so that the rest of the money you fit take save money. When they cancel your paper, you go get rest of mind to go back home. That's the problem many people get. Let me tell you guys a story. I was in a lawyer's house one day, office. And I saw one Igbo guy just enter. You know, if you sit down, they go up, they sit down, they go up, they go up. Down. I know if you could talk to them. My phone number is on my YouTube channel, Solomon Okereke Vlog. So what am I trying to say? This guy was going up and down, sitting down. I say, bro, say, you know, say, they don't seize my aduro. I say, what thing happened? I say, how many years you don't use? He say, I don't use like 5-6 years. I say, you never save money. He say, come, shishi, I no save. I say, why? He say, my brother, if you see the house where they built, I don't regret though. I no see money where I go take, go back home. Blah, 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 blah. Me, I no get waiting, I won't talk. You understand?
Thank you for always watching Linda's TV show. I will see you again in my next video. Remain blessed. I appreciate each and every one of you. And keep on watching Linda's TV show. If you have not yet subscribed, please, I beg you to do that so that you'll be getting more updates from me. Bye-bye.